Hi besties, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today's video is very exciting. I feel like I had an amazing reading month. I'm obsessed with every single book that I read this month. So today I'm going to be sharing and talking about the books that I read in October. And I didn't read much. I read 5 books, but something is something. I know I've talked about these books that I'm going to be sharing today, like a lot in my videos. And I was kind of like debating whether or not I should make this video, but a lot of you did ask me to do this video. So here I am. I love it. This is going to be kind of like a bonus video for the week because now I post 2 times a week, but this week is going to be 3 times. And I'm so excited, and I really want to say thank you all for supporting me and following me on my Instagram. We reached 10k yesterday. Well, for me it was yesterday. I'm filming this on Tuesday. Yesterday was Monday, and insane, you guys. I love you guys so much. All the messages, all the congratulations, they made my day. Okay, let's get started with the books that I read in October. The first book that I read was It Happened One Summer by Tessa Bailey. Oh my gosh. This became one of my new favorite books. Like, all of these became my new favorite books, but this one was such a great book. I want to read the second book so badly. Okay, but this book is the first book in a series. It's a series about 2 sisters. So this is the first book of the first sister, which is Piper, and the second book is about Piper's sister. So It Happened One Summer tells the story of this girl, Piper. So Piper is this it girl in California. She's kind of an influencer, Instagram influencer. She goes to a lot of parties. That's literally like her job. She goes to parties. But the thing is that Piper's stepfather actually like pays her bills, pays everything. So the story starts with Piper going to a party, normal of her going to a party, but she went to this party with her current boyfriend of 3 weeks. Piper is kind of an influencer, but kind of celebrity. So she's very known, like, she walks into a room and people know her. So when she's at this party with her boyfriend, everyone like sees her, knows her, and this boyfriend of hers decides to break up with her in the middle of the party and says some horrible things to her, like so horrible. I was like, oh my gosh, what is this? Basically, he breaks up with her, but the entire time he's breaking up with her, everyone at the party is seeing the situation. And she like already knew that TMZ was going to be all over her breakup, and she leaves the party, and that's exactly what happens. Everyone is spreading rumors and it's becoming a mess. And on her way home, she decides to throw an insane party because she feels that she needs to, because of the breakup. So she breaks into a hotel's rooftop, invites hundreds of people, and well, it was the party of the century. But she ended up in jail, and her little sister had to break her out. And I mentioned her stepfather because obviously she ended up in jail, and her stepfather is so mad at her because of the hotel, because of the money that she wasted, jail time, everything. When she gets home from jail, the stepfather decides that he's going to send her out to another city. And basically city, not city, small town, a very, very small town for 3 months. Without a lot of money, she needs to grow up, she needs to take care of herself, and that's exactly what happens. But the little sister decides to go with Piper. They get to this small town, and that's when Piper meets the grumpiest guy ever, which is Brandon. It's an enemies to lovers, grumpy sunshine. I'm not gonna say anything more about the story because that's all you need to know, and so good, the spice, the love, and I cannot wait to read the second book. Okay, so the next book that I read was a book of the month pick, which was for the October book of the month, Obsessed. Okay, so this is The X-Hex by Erin Sterling. First of all, I love this cover so much. Like, it screams Halloween, screams October, but with the romance. Okay, so I talked about this book in one of my latest videos. It's kind of like a fun read with a little bit of romance, with a little bit of spice, and with a little bit of adventure. And those are my favorite things. Okay, so this book is about Vivi, and the book actually starts with kind of like a backstory, so kind of then and now. So what happens in then, which is the backstory of everything, is when Vivi is 18, if I'm remembering correctly, and she just found out that her entire family from her mother's side are witches, and she is a witch. She found out at 18 because her mother like never told her. She wanted to protect her from like all the witchy things. Something happens with Vivi's mother and she is left with her aunt and her cousin. So she moves in with her aunt and her cousin. So the summer, I think before starting college, she meets this other witch, male witch. And this guy is named Riz. So they kind of date for the summer and they break up because Vivi finds out that Riz has been keeping a very huge secret from her. And obviously she was very like heartbroken, and the same night that they broke up, she was at her house with her cousin and her aunt, and she was like in a bathtub crying and listening to music, drinking vodka, and one thing led to another. And Vivi and her cousin were kind of like fooling around with magic. They tried to curse Riz, but kind of for funsies, like it wasn't real magic. But when they did, weird things happened in the same room. And they were like so weird out, so they stopped. They never talked about that ever. So then it hops to 9 years later, and Vivi is all grown up. She graduated college, she works at the same college. An event brings Riz back to the small town, and weird things start happening to him. Like weird things. You're gonna find out what happens if you read the book. I was not expecting a lot of things, and I was kind of pleasantly surprised. I read this book in one day, by the way, and it's so quick to read. It's a fun read. I never got bored. I love the story, the romance, the spies, the adventure, the mission. Like, loved it. 5 out of 5 stars. So the next book that I read, I don't have it in paperback, I have it on my Kindle, but it's Building Bridges by Leah Fairchild. And this is a romance, new adult romance. I also talked about this book, I think, in one of my last videos, so I'm really going to skim through it. Basically, this book is about a man, a former soldier, that moves back home because of two family losses, which were two women, two mothers, who passed away because of an accident. So he moves back home to take care of his family. And this man is named Logan Bridges. So the Bridges family is mostly based off men. And they all think they have kind of like a curse with women. And they all think that they are cursed because women in their family leave or die or just disappear. And there's only one little girl in this family. So they're all men. And there's one little girl. So one day something happens to one of the children and they need to go to the ER. But nothing like serious, but they go to the ER and Logan gets to the hospital and he's there, he's helping, and he runs into a girl from his past that works at the hospital. And that is Molly. So that's the love interest of the story. It's really cute. And I really liked the writing style. It was very easy to read, which is very important for me. It's a romance. It's that kind of book that makes you like believe in love. So good. So I read The Kiss Quotient by Helen Huang. Oh my god. I have talked about this book so much, so I'm not going to give another synopsis of this book. Like, I've mentioned this book like in a lot of videos and in my podcast also. So this is kind of fake dating where they're they're both in denial. I was so surprised when I read this book. It was very different from other romance novels. Like, I loved the spies, the love, the romance. So good. One of my favorite books. If you want to hear more about this book, go watch any of my recent videos. Okay, I know what you're waiting for, and I left this book last because it's so good. And this book is Reminders of Him by Colleen Hoover. This is her new novel that's coming out January something. I cried with this book four different times. So good. And like the last pages, I was like just bawling. Like I couldn't even read. Like I was just crying. Like so good. 5 out of 5 stars. If you haven't pre-ordered this book, what are you doing? Like please go pre-order this book. And I also get questions on how I got this book, and I was gifted the book, and I'm so freaking grateful because she's my favorite author, you guys know. So I'm only going to read the back of the book because I don't want to give anything away, not yet. So it says, after serving 5 years in prison for a tragic mistake, Kenna Rowan returns to the town where it all went wrong, hoping to reunite with her 4-year-old daughter. But the bridges Kenna burned are proving impossible to rebuild. Everyone in her daughter's life is determined to shut Kenna out, no matter how hard she works to prove herself. The only person who hasn't closed the door on her completely is Ledger Ward, a local bar owner and one of the few remaining links to Kenna's daughter. But if anyone were to discover how Ledger is slowly becoming an important part of Kenna's life, both would risk losing the trust of everyone important to them. The two form a connection despite the pressure surrounding them, but as their romance grows, so does the risk. Kenna must find a way to absolve the mistakes of her past in order to build a future out of hope and healing. It's a heartbreaking book, but it does have a happy ending, just so you know. I loved it with all my heart. Like, I loved it so much. It doesn't top my favorite book by Colleen Hoover, which is Ugly Love, but it's a really, really good book. And those were all the books that I read in October. That's the video for today. I hope you liked the new background, and I hope you liked the room makeover video because it was so fun to make. So I love you guys. If you like the video, subscribe down below, turn on the notification bell to get notified when I upload more videos. And I will see you in my next one. Bye. Saw you walking in the street one day, it was a Sunday. You had flowers in your hand, you were dancing with your phone.